I know you want to create this amazing cinematic scene using Adobe After Effects or DaVinci Resolve. So in this video, let me show you how to make these impressive visual effects by using Adobe After Effects. But if you are DaVinci Resolve user, don't skip this video. You can still get an idea of the process by watching this video, and you can replicate it by yourself using DaVinci Resolve. This will improve your skills a lot, and I will make the next video on DaVinci Resolve so you don't have to worry about it. Just give it a like and subscribe to this channel if you are watching this video for the very first time. And one more thing, this is not a step-by-step tutorial because I am assuming you are not an absolute beginner. You know the basic tools of Adobe After Effects. So this is Vikas from Sky Line Motions, and without wasting any time, let's jump into After Effects and get started. Alright, so open your After Effects, take a new project and create a new composition. Set a resolution 1920 by 1080, frame rate 30, duration make it 10 seconds long. You can call this render comp. Let's import a background image first. Right click on the project window, go to import, file and select an image that you want. You can download all these assets from the link given in the description. Let's create a new separate composition for the background. Leave all the setting as it is. Call this background comp. Drag and drop that image into the background composition. Scale it down and fit the image inside of it. Now go back to the render composition. Drag and drop background comp inside of it. And after that, let's create a text. Select the text tool, go to character and select your favorite font style. I'm using GoodTimes extra light, size 200 pixel. Click here and type anything whatever you like and align the text to the center of the frame. Now let's create glowing neon kind of text. So go to effect and preset, search for glow. Drag and drop the glow effect on the text layer. Go to effect control, set the glow radius value 10. Then create a duplicate of the glow effect and set the value 50. Create one more time and set the glow radius 200. Now we have perfect glow effect on the text that is looking very nice. After that, let's import one more image that is going to be our foreground. So this is the image and I will use this part of the image. You can cut this part using Photoshop and save the file in the PNG format, something like this one. Or you can download this PNG file from the link given in the description. Now create one more composition, call it foreground and leave the setting as it is. Drag and drop the PNG file into this composition, scale it up just a little bit and set the position like this. Now let's make those area a little bit darker where you want to place your model. Just create a duplicate, select the top layer and mask that area. Go to effect and presets and search for curves. Apply curves effect on the top layer and drag the RGB curves down just a little bit. Then go back to the render composition, drag and drop the foreground comp inside of it. And then we have to import green screen footage of your model. Drag and drop that footage on the little composition icon here to create a new separate composition using the same setting of the footage. So this is the footage we have. You can shoot your video like this. After that, you can apply key light effect on it to remove green screen. Pick that green color from the footage. Open a screen matte, adjust the clip black and clip white properties. You can switch alpha channel from here to get perfect result. Basically, we have to make white section pure white and black section pure black. Once done, set the screen softness value 2.0 and switch back the alpha mode to normal RGB. Now let's create a mask around the model using paint tool and animate the mask path if you want. And then we have to apply levels effect on the footage. Go to effect control and set the gamma 0.3. Now switch back to the render composition, drag and drop the footage comp inside of it. After that, scale it down and place the model on the mountain. Now select the foreground and the footage and pre-compose it. Give it a name, call it foreground comp. Now let's apply tint effect and make it black and white. You can also apply levels and do some setting such as set the gamma 0.15 and output white 200. And finally, let's animate the scene. Create a 3D camera, use the preset 35mm. Go to the layer and take a new null object. Connect the pick whip of the camera with the null object, and now we can use the null object as a camera controller. After that, convert all the layers into a 3D layer. Open the position property of these three layers. Set the Z position value of the text layer negative 750 and negative 1500 in the foreground composition. Now bring out the scale property, scale it down and reposition the text layer as well as the foreground composition. Now open the property of the null object, which is camera controller, and animate the Y rotation. You can simply put the Y rotation value negative 1 at very beginning of this animation and plus 1 at the end of this animation. Now we have a smooth animation, but we have to fix this issue. You can see here. Just go to Effect and Preset and search for Motion Tile. Apply Motion Tile effect on the background comp and set the output width 150 and output height 150. And don't forget to check mirror edges. Now you can copy the same Motion Tile effect and paste it on the foreground comp as well. Perfect. Now I want to animate the text. So open the text layer, click on Animate, add tracking. Turn on the stopwatch button for the tracking amount at very beginning and set it 50. Go to the end of this animation and set the value 10. After that, let's create an adjustment layer. Apply hue and saturation on it. Increase the master saturation plus 20. Apply curves on it. Set the graph like this. Remember, this will depend on the image color and mood that you want to create. So adjust these settings according to you. Now let's apply brightness and contrast. Increase the brightness and set it 50. Perfect. Now we have to fix the color bending. You can apply noise effect and set the amount of noise 3 or 5%. Now let's import particles overlay. Drag and drop into the render composition. Click on the toggle switches and set the blending mode screen. And here we have atmospheric particles. And finally, let's create a vignette over here. So take a new black solid layer. Select the ellipse tool from here. Hold Ctrl and double click on this ellipse tool. Open the mask property. Check the option inverted. Set the mask feather 200. And you can set the opacity of this layer 50%. At the end, you can turn on the motion blur for all the layers and done. Go to the full screen and let's have a look. Absolutely amazing, right? And that's a wrap for this video. I hope you like it. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to drop a comment below this video. If you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.